What up? This is T Reezy. Welcome to episode 6 of Reezy Duz It, where today I'll be discussing the passing of late Memphis rapper Gangsta Boo. Gangsta Boo's death was confirmed by her former group mate and label mate DJ Paul of 36 Mafia. According to reports, Gangsta Boo's body was found on her front porch of a house in Memphis. Reports say that Gangsta Boo had went to a concert on New Year's Eve, a local Memphis concert, where I'm hearing that she performed at a concert, her and A-Ball and MJG. And later that night, it's confirmed that her brother ended up having to go to a hospital for overdosing, which he was found to be okay. And later that night, Gangsta Boo was found dead on her porch. And according to authorities, they found a fentanyl-laced substance in her purse. This makes the third member of 36 Mafia that's passed away in the past maybe 5 years or so. Koosta Nigga, Lord Infamous, and now Gangsta Boo. Gangsta Boo appeared on albums with 36 Mafia such as Misty Styles, World Domination Chapter 1, When the Smoke Clears. She was on the Choices soundtrack album. Gangsta Boo left 36 Mafia in the early 2000s. She worked with such artists as Gucci Mane, Lil Jon, Outkast, E-40, T.I., The Game, and many more. Gangsta Boo is a legend in the game, man. Gangsta Boo is a legend in the game. She might be, she's definitely one of my favorite artists out the South. Hearing her on songs with 3-6, a lot of times she outdid the guys in the group. You feel me? Boo is definitely legendary, and Boo definitely had that flow. And Boo definitely influences female artists you're hearing now, like maybe a Glorilla, Cardi B, Megan Thee Stallion. Gangsta Boo was the truth, man, and she'll definitely be missed. Gangsta Boo's brother, who according to reports OD'd before she did and went to the hospital and ended up being okay, according to sources, Gangsta Boo's brother was incarcerated for close to 20 years, if not 20 years. And according to comments on TMZ, people are leaving comments saying that it should have been him, not her, that he's worthless and all this and that. So not only does he have to deal with the death of his sister, but he's dealing with these comments as well. But people are entitled to their opinions. But Gangsta Boo will definitely be missed, man. It's a sad day for Memphis, sad day for Tennessee, sad day for the South, sad day for hip-hop, man. Just want to give my condolences to Gangsta Boo's family and friends. She will be greatly missed. I just saw an episode of Drink Champs, Gangsta Boo's episode of Drink Champs, which was very entertaining. Very entertaining. Gangsta Boo started rapping at the age of 14, if I'm not mistaken. And her first official song was released at the age of 16. Gangsta Boo, she jumped on the scene with 36 Mafia, but that Where Them Dollars At and that album that had Where Them Dollars At is what put Gangsta Boo on as a solo artist in the rap game, man. Gangsta Boo is definitely one of the pioneers of the Memphis rap scene. And like I said, man, my condolences to Gangsta Boo and her family. But I say all this to say this, man. That fentanyl is something serious. Just, everyone just be careful. You know what I mean? Whatever choices you make out here, just be careful and just move wisely. I just want to say, you know, there's a lot of rappers glorifying drug use and things like that. But I just want to tell you, don't believe that song. That nigga's wrong. You know what I mean? So, everybody just have a blessed day. You know what I mean? And just make wise choices out here. Rest in peace, Gangsta Boo. And guess what? Boy, you should have known by now. Reezy Duz it.